Welcome back to the Matt Armstrong BMX channel. Today we're gonna get straight into it. We'll be lowering a Audi A6 C7, a 2012 plate, on H&R springs. So you know how these how-to videos work. We're just gonna get straight into it. If you are new here and you haven't clicked subscribe, click that subscribe button. So let's start things off.
You can see the arch gap there.
So it's the Audi A6 C7 shape. It's a 3-litre TDI Quattro. It's on 20-inch wheels, and we want to bring it down about 30 mil on the H&R springs. So I'm going to start with the rear because I can see them upsetting there. I'm going to switch to the GoPro, and I'll try and talk you through it, but I do want to get the job done. So peace, let's see it.
Okay, so we're starting on the rear. First thing, these two bolts on the strut, we'll undo them first. So I've just got the jack supporting the whole thing. 216 mm at the top. Let's undo these. Those two bolts are out now. The next one, I've got to try and get to this spring. So in the way is this control arm here, where there's two bolts here and two bolts there. Now, if you are removing all this, you are probably going to have to get your four wheel alignment again, which he is going to do after this, but let's remove that and remove that. I'll have to remove a bit of this to get out of the way, but there's just a little Torx underneath. After we move that and that, we're going to have to move this arm here. Now this is like a camber adjusting arm, and I'd say you're going to have to get it all aligned up with the wheel alignment afterwards anyway, unless you can sort of get it in the right place. But I wouldn't sort of do a guessing game on that. I would go and get it done properly. Now this arm is out, so you've got the 18 mm which sits at the bottom there, and the 18 mm at the top. Next one is this top camber arm, which is adjustable as well. Oh, and also I'm going to undo this anti-roll bar here. And then we're going to compress the spring to get it out. And if I said that was easy, then I'd be lying, because it took me ages to do the other one. Roll bar, I don't know if you can see, just the link here. Undone that bolt. Now I've got to do this top bolt, undo that, and everything should drop down. Then I've still got to compress the spring to get it out. Camber arm is out. This will drop down. I would suggest kind of loosening the brake, so that's not putting any stress on that. Compress the spring out. There's your bottom mount, there's your top mount. It's got places you can sit. Spring is compressed. Let's get the new spring. Here's the new spring. So there's your new spring, H&R, and there's your old spring. They're literally exactly the same height, but I assume these coils will compress a lot compared to these, which will give it that extra 30 mil lower or so. So I've got to compress this, get that on, and put it all back to how we started. The spring is in. That took absolutely ages getting that in. So now I've got to get this top arm back on, that arm back on, the roll bar connected again, and put the wheel back on, and the strut, obviously. Let's do it. So that's all on, tight, spring's in. I've adjusted the camber bolts, just kind of done it to where I think they should go.
This is a Chucky Beat production.
I'm going to try and get them actually the same each side. Onto the fronts now. There's two control arms. I had problems taking that thing out, so I'm going to go with these two, take those out. Then I'm going to undo the anti-roll bar linkage there, and bottom of the strut here, and disconnect all this, the brake hoses, and then the four bolts at the top. It should be, that's really it on the front, so see how long that takes. Okay, the strut is off, and if I said that was easier, again, I'd be lying. Now I'm just taking it off. You don't need compressors for this one, because obviously there's no, the spring is quite small anyway, because it's an S-line, so I'm getting it off now. Old spring off, new spring. There's really not much difference in size, but I'm assuming this is going to compress down a lot. So there's a little line here. You've got to line it up with that line there before you put it on.
Right, we have quickly like smashed through this, so the how-to is literally not very good at all. We're just tightening the wheel bolts up now, and then we're just gonna take a little test drive, seat the springs in, but it's definitely gonna need four-wheel alignment, obviously, because those adjustable camber arms, which I showed you on the back, and we'll see how it looks. I'm not gonna show you it right now, just wanna kind of reverse it off, take the handbrake off, then you'll see the result. If you have any questions, make sure you put in the comment box below. Peace. Guys, this has been really rushed. It took me like all day to do this. If I'm gonna be honest, it's a horrible job, so if you wanna try and do it on your drive, I'd probably advise not to. As you can see, the outcome looks really good. It's gonna take a few weeks for it to seat in properly, but the arch gap seems to have gone nicely there. Looks a lot nicer. Much nicer. This is a terribly edited video, terribly filmed video, but I just wanted to get the job done. It's looking quite nice. Obviously, he's got to go and get his four-wheel alignment done now, and then we're all out. Make sure you subscribe. Peace.
Is there any problems? Any bottles? Any models? Would like to swallow? Like gobble, gobble. Talking gobble, gobble. Keep extended clips, and they fill with hollows.
22 hoes on me, 22 clothes on me.